Sophie Bảo Trân xin kính chào quý khán giả của đài Little Saigon TV đến với chương trình What's Up. Kính thưa quý vị, hy vọng là quý vị đã từng xem những cái phóng sự mà Bảo Trân đã làm ngay tại Phú Quốc, Việt Nam. Với hãng Red Boat, Bảo Trân đã đến xưởng nước mắm và tham quan cũng như là tìm hiểu thêm về công ty này. Đặc biệt hôm nay Bảo Trân đã mời đến CEO của công ty Red Boat là cũng rất là nhiều người cũng từng biết đến là ex-Apple engineer là đã từng làm cho hãng Apple. Sau đó thì ông đã bỏ rơi công việc của mình và trở thành một người mà toàn là sản xuất nước mắm không. Thưa quý vị, Bảo Trân xin phép là tại vì Bảo Trân đã từng làm cái interview, cái phóng sự bằng tiếng Việt rồi.
Right.
Và có rất là nhiều bạn trẻ muốn tìm hiểu thêm về nước mắm Việt Nam, okay, cũng như là hãng Red Boat, cho nên là cho Bảo Trân xin phỏng vấn anh Cường bằng tiếng Anh nha.
Okay.
With over 100 million Vietnamese around the world, living in different countries, speaking different languages, achieving success in various industries, there is something that we have in common. Nước mắm, fish sauce, runs in our blood. The golden amber liquid is essential to all regions of Vietnamese cuisine. Fish sauce was once thought of as stinky to foreigners, but now it is revered as a secret ingredient by top chefs globally. For one particular Vietnamese American, fish sauce runs so deep in his veins that he left his Silicon Valley job as an Apple engineer and moved to Phú Quốc, Vietnam, to pursue his passion of creating the purest, most authentic first press extra virgin fish sauce. I'm Sophie Bảo Trân, and today on What's Up, I invite you to meet Cuong, Pham, CEO and founder of Red Boat Fish Sauce.
Thank you, Bảo Trân. Yes, give me the opportunity to meet and we can discuss further if any information you need about Red Boat.
Yeah, and you know, I was supposed to meet you in Phú Quốc. I flew all the way there and
I
you ran away from me.
I felt so bad. The first time we had the major storm, you probably saw the flooding.
Yeah.
But then there was some other emergency back home that, yeah, you know, I had to go back and address. So
no worries.
So, I feel so bad that I miss you.
I learned so much about fish sauce when I went on the tour.
Okay.
First of all, that it's created in these big barrels.
Yes.
And, you know, and the thing that really surprised me about your factory is before I came to any fish sauce factory, a lot of people warned me. They said, it's gonna smell really, really bad. Like someone told me as soon as they went to a fish sauce factory, they stepped out of the car and they went right back into the car and they did not take the tour.
I see.
But when I came, I was like, is there a fish sauce factory here? I don't smell anything. Can you talk a little bit about your facilities?
Yes. Basically, fish sauce is easy to make, mm-hmm, but to make it traditionally without using any additives, without using any preservative, the way it was made hundreds of years ago. Hmm. It's required pay attention to all the details along the way. So let me give you the little background about why fish sauce from Phú Quốc is so special.
Hmm.
Three key factors with any product, good product, starting with good material, raw material, which is the anchovies, the black anchovies that swim around the Gulf of Thailand. Mm. Then when people make fish sauce from there, that's gonna give you the highest protein contents, mm-hmm, compared to other anchovies, mm, from other regions. That's number one. Number two is the process. Process means how they make it. And the first important step of making fish sauce is on the boat. So when you catch the fish, you salt it immediately with the right amount of ratio. Once the fish is salted, then it's preserved. It's not going to be rotten, right? Mm. That's the key thing. And the third thing would be fermentation environment, which is Phú Quốc is ideal because the weather, and you see those wooden barrels, mm-hmm, you know, the fermentation. So the fish is fermented in the wooden barrels and then the fermentation times. So the key thing that you don't smell any funky rotten fish, mm-hmm, because our fish, our boat, we catch it, we salt it immediately on the boat when we got it. So that's why the fish is preserved. And that's why when we load it, we stay in the barrels there and you don't get any funky smell at all.
Oh, I see. Yeah. I see. So because the fish is instantly preserved,
correct.
That's why all, you know, your facilities don't smell like rotten
right.
fish.
Right.
But now that you told us, what would you do if the other facilities copied your method and then they would do the same thing too? Then your competitors would know.
Yeah, as I said.
Are you scared?
No.
Why is
paying
that?
Attention uh-huh. to details, meaning mm-hmm. we have to be able to monitor and control all the process mm-hmm. vertically mm-hmm. from catching until the end products. Mm-hmm. Okay. There's about 1,500 factories out there. Mm-hmm. Only a few of them, they catch their own fish, mm-hmm. you know, because like, you know, they have to pay attention to how, when the fish is caught. And the deckhand or the fishermen, the crew, they understand what's the requirement. A lot of the time you have fishermen go out, catch the fish and sell it to the smaller factory. Mm-hmm. So the care of the fish is not the same like if you actually gonna make it to become the end product that you sell into the finished product mm-hmm. by Red Boat.
Is that why Red Boat is a little bit more expensive than the other Nuk Mama brands, fish sauce and
it's a lot more expensive for obvious reason.
Uh-huh.
Red Boat is first press, just like olive oil, you know.
Uh-huh.
First press meaning like after the 12 months fermentation in the barrel, the first drain from the fish, mm-hmm. you know, after all the enzyme mm-hmm. breaking down the fish, give you the nuance, you know, the best of the fish.
Mm-hmm.
is come out from the first press.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we have 40N is the protein contents of the product. And that's why it's more expensive because you only get like...
So you make a little less, right?
A lot because less.
Because it's first press.
The first press, yes.
So what do the other fish sauce companies do?
Actually, from my understanding, it's like they blend it, right? So if they, let's say if they catch the fish mm-hmm. or however they make it,
mm-hmm.
in order to tell what's the grade of the fish, you look mm-hmm. at the nutritional facts,
mm-hmm.
the protein contents.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't matter what they claim in the front, mm-hmm. I don't care, but you're looking at the nutrition facts mm-hmm. and it say how much protein in there.
Mm-hmm.
The higher the protein, meaning the higher
the amount of anchovies.
The protein contents uh-huh. in there, that's mean that the higher the Dodan, yes,
yeah.
I mean the quality
yeah.
fish.
Mm-hmm.
And only the first press is giving you the higher contents because all the subsequent press, then you get more diluted down. In order to make it cheaper, mm-hmm. they have to dilute it down.
What do they dilute it with, water or
it could
what?
Be different method, but they can just run through more salt water so they can get more fish sauce from there.
I see. And you know, I also heard that, you know, some companies who, you know, for example, the fish sauce factory might smell and you know, it's because the fish sauce smells bad, so they have to add chemicals in to get rid of that smell.
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes. I mean, the way we make it traditionally, mm-hmm. as I said, hundreds of years ago, we don't have any chemicals to fix the problem that it didn't come out right. Remember, the very first thing you do is salting the fish immediately with the right amount of salt, the right kind of salt. And if you do that and then you monitor it, you maintaining it throughout the fermentation times, enough times, then you don't have that funky smell. Then you don't have to worry about diluting it or pasteurizing it, meaning that you cook the fish sauce to get rid of that smell. And then when you get rid of that, then you have to introduce some of the flavor, mm-hmm. artificial flavor to put it back in again, but that's not the real fish sauce.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason we know, chefs knows about this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So when they discover and they compare and they can see the differences.
Cảm ơn quý vị đã theo dõi phần 1 của chương trình What's Up cùng với Sophie Bảo Trân. Mời quý vị đón xem phần 2 trên đài Little Saigon TV.